Welcome to Observe Dashboards. You can find dashboards on the left-hand menu, and then you can find dashboards provided by applications and or custom dashboards created from scratch. You can use this filter to navigate dashboards by application and then use them as is to see the related data. If I want to create a dashboard myself, I'll go to the top right menu and click New Dashboard. And now I'm brought within the dashboard editor. The first thing I'll do is title my dashboard, and then I can begin to add things to my dashboard with this button here, or I could use the button within the dashboard itself and see the various different options for what can be added to my dashboard. The top three here are most important as they relate to the actual data that can be brought into a dashboard. Beyond that, we have different objects which can be used to help organize your dashboard and make it more appealing. And lastly, we have parameters and filters, drop-down filters, and open text search bars, which can be incorporated into your dashboard to interact with the underlying data. However, we'll cover this in more detail in a separate video. To begin with dashboards, let's look at the three dashboard cards first. And first, I'll select a dataset table, which merely prompts me to select a dataset, which can be brought in a tabular form into my dashboard. I'll search for container logs and see that this card is brought in with a default format and no title. If I want to edit this, I'll need to click on the pencil icon, which will bring me into the dashboard card editor. From here, I can title this card, and then I can choose to rearrange or actually maybe even hide columns that I don't need to see in this particular view. And then when I go back to the dashboard, I'll see those changes reflected. Lastly, I can rearrange this card or resize it. Next, I'll add another card to my dashboard, and I'll move on to the dataset visualization, which also prompts me to select a dataset. And to bring it full circle, I'll look at container logs again. And so no visualization is configured by default, so I'll open it up to edit it, again title it, and then confirm that the visualization is configured properly using the expression builder and also the visualization settings. Once I'm happy with this, I'll again go back to my dashboard and rearrange this one as well. Now, last but not least, I'll add a metric visualization, which brings me directly into the dashboard card editor, where I'll select a metric here. I can look at CPU utilization. Maybe I want to change the aggregation function. I'll keep the grouping as is. I might need to actually filter to my app namespace. Last but not least, title it. And now I'm complete with this card. And I could go back to the dashboard, but if I wanted to navigate between cards and continue editing further, I could also use this menu up here to quickly switch between the two. Going back to my dashboard, I'll see my final card here, rearrange it. And I could continue further by adding collapsible sections, text blocks or images and or parameters and filters to my dashboard. However, I'll stop here and I can save these changes, leave the editor, and now I can see my new dashboard in its full form.